Hello, and welcome to What's That with Prisma Cloud, the show that breaks down complex cloud security topics into easy-to-understand concepts. I'm Steve Giguere, developer advocate for Bridgecrew by Palo Alto Networks, and today I'll explain CloudNative Application Protection Platform, or CNAPPs. We can't talk about CNAPPs without first talking about the evolution of CloudNative security. So, let's start with the basics. What does CloudNative mean, anyway? Well, it depends on who you ask. According to the CloudNative Computing Foundation, or CNCF, CloudNative technologies are what allow organizations to build and run scalable applications in dynamic environments, such as public, private, and hybrid clouds. Some examples of these technologies are containers, service meshes, microservices, application programming interfaces, or APIs. For small to medium businesses looking to do more in the cloud, these technologies are game changers. Being CloudNative can be a huge enabler for three big reasons. Number one, faster time to market. Number two, more cost effective. And number three, drives continuous innovation. These benefits made CloudNative development extremely enticing for companies and developers who wanted to expand their online products and services. So the CloudNative computing revolution was born. For app developers, this was like being turned loose in the Wild West. The possibilities were endless. In fact, it was CloudNative technologies that enabled the world's new favorite pastime, binge watching. When Netflix pivoted from DVD by mail company to the world's largest on-demand content service, it was because they shifted their entire architecture from monolith to microservices. By doing this, they removed the blockers that historically stood between developing and testing new features and then deploying them to production. Thanks to cloud infrastructure, Netflix was able to do the behind-the-scenes engineering with no interruptions to your streaming service. Now, any CloudNative strategy fundamentally is an application-first strategy. Its focus is on how applications are built and deployed, which means organizations need to rethink how they approach security. Containers offer a good place to start. Starting in about 2013 with the arrival of Docker, containers quickly became a fundamental building block of modern IT infrastructure. At their core, containers bundle an application's code and dependencies, making it easier to deploy them in any environment and start them quickly. Because they are cloud native, container workloads can run anywhere, in a private cloud, public cloud, or hybrid cloud. This makes them an ideal choice for building scalable, agile application environments. With this in mind, how do you secure the Wild West of app development without putting a chokehold on fast development and easy scalability, some of the very things that keep you competitive? Enter CloudNative Security. The end goal of CloudNative is the accelerated, seamless delivery of new applications and features to customers. So, finding and fixing security vulnerabilities as early as possible during development is imperative. The bedrock of all things CloudNative needs to be CloudNative application protection. Security needs to be embedded throughout the entire application lifecycle, even at the earliest stages. This is what is known as DevSecOps. So what does securing CloudNative applications look like? While developers are committing code and building container images, security protocols should be in place to identify open source, container image, and security gaps such as vulnerabilities and malware. DevSecOps principles need to be embedded at every stage of the development lifecycle. Beyond that, developers need to use cloud security tools during each stage of development to make sure their CloudNative apps and infrastructures are compliant and secure. All of this is done to help mitigate risks early on. However, as applications remain vulnerable at runtime while they are deployed, security professionals have to consider all avenues of threats. They can't rest on their laurels when it comes to securing the full application lifecycle. From code changes that have not been tested but slipped through to production, to zero-day attacks, runtime applications continue to require examination. Let's recap what we've learned in this episode of What's That? CloudNative empowers digital transformation by leaving undifferentiated IT infrastructure to the cloud service providers. This allows organizations to focus on building and running apps that deliver competitive advantage, connect their workforces, and serve their customers. However, development teams evolving from classic to CloudNative development almost always outpace security. Meanwhile, cloud security teams struggle to apply new tools and technologies every time a new security risk is highlighted. In response, Security needs to shift left to ensure cloud-native vulnerabilities are identified and remediated as early as possible in the development process. What we are witnessing here is an industry-wide attempt for security to catch up to both time and technology as they hurtle headlong into the future. The cloud-native era represents a fundamental shift in the way that enterprise security has traditionally been delivered. Stay tuned for part two of this episode, where we start putting the puzzle pieces together for cloud-native application protection platforms. I'm Steve Giguere. This is What's That with Prisma Cloud. Until next time.